everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about the difference between the limit of a series and the sum of a series. And in this particular problem, we've been given the function 4096 to the n over 2 power, to the power of n over 2, divided by 8 to the power 2n. And we've been asked to find two things, the limit as the series approaches infinity, and also the sum of the infinite series. So let's tackle the limit first. The way that we're going to find the limit, and you'll recall from learning limits earlier in your calculus course that you'll want to simplify your function as much as possible first, and then see if you can evaluate the limit just by plugging in the number you're approaching. In this case, we're approaching infinity, so we want to see what this function does as it approaches infinity. If we can't just evaluate by plugging in infinity or some very large number, then we can always try to manipulate the function further to see what we can do to evaluate the limit. So in this case, we're going to simplify as much as we can first, and let's just work with the function first by, remember, we'll say the limit is as n approaches infinity, but we can, looks like, simplify both the numerator and the denominator of this fraction. So what we'll do is we'll say, instead of 4096 to the n over 2, we'll call it 4096 to the 1/2 times n, which is the same thing, right? 1/2 times n is n over 2, divided by, instead of 8 to the 2n, we'll call it 8 squared, and bring the n out here. So it'll be 8 squared, that whole thing, raised to the n power, which we can do. And these are just laws of exponents and rules from algebra of working with exponents. 8 to the 2n is the same thing as 8 squared, and then that raised to the n power. So again, with the numerator, now we've got 4096 to the 1/2. Remember that anything raised to the 1/2 power is the same thing as the square root. So we essentially have the square root of 4096 raised to the n power. And then in the denominator, 8 squared is 64. So we've got 64 raised to the n power. The square root of 4096 turns out to be 64. So we'll have 64 raised to the n power over 64 raised to the n power. And we can see here that this fraction is going to end up simplifying to 1. So we don't even actually have to evaluate at infinity because there's no variable involved in our function any longer. We've simplified it to 1. What this tells us through simplification is that the graph of our function is just n equal 1 or x equal 1. And we're going to have a line here like this, right? And it's always going to be 1. So as x approaches infinity, right, as we go farther and farther out towards infinity, the graph is always going to approach 1, right? We've got a value here, and this is equal to 1 on our graph, and the function is always going to be at 1. So the limit as n approaches infinity of the function will be equal to 1. Now we want to talk about the sum of the infinite series. And to figure out the sum, we can either start with our original function, or we can go ahead and tackle the function from this point because we didn't change anything. All we did was simplify. So if we're talking about the infinite sum, right, we can say the sum of this series from n equals 1 to infinity, right? If we just start plugging in numbers, right, we start with n equals 1, we'd get 64 to the first power over 64 to the first power for our first term. Then when we plug in 2, we get 64 squared over 64 squared. When we plug in 3, we'd get 64 cubed over 64 cubed. You obviously get the idea. What this shows us is that the sum of our series, 64 to the first over 64 to the first is 1. 64 squared over 64 squared is also 1. 64 cubed over 64 cubed is 1. So what we're going to get is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 forever. And you can see that we're just going to continue adding 1 to the sum of the series infinitely, which means that the sum of the series is equal to infinity. And that should make sense to us because if we look at our graph here of the equation, right, and we're taking the series from n equals 1, so we're starting here, right, and we want to know the area under the curve from here all the way out to infinity, right? Well, if the line, if our graph never gets any closer to the x-axis, right, and we've always got this area, we're going to continue to have this area forever. So the farther out we go, the more we're going to add to our area, and it's never going to stop. This is always going to, the area under the curve is always going to increase as long as we keep moving out to the right, and we'll end up with essentially 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 all the way to infinity as the area under the curve. So again, the limit as n approaches infinity is equal to 1 because the graph of this line is always going to stay at y equals 1. The sum of the series, though, will be equal to infinity because the area under the graph will always keep increasing. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.